You're listening to Time Crisis on Beast One.
Anyway.
Genius idea.
So we saw another one of these conversations, which I hate, where Wendy's talks some shit about IHOP. And then Moon Pie, for some reason, Moon Pie's always on Wendy's. Like, Wendy's always talks some
shit. What's Moon Pie?
You know, like those like chocolate covered, it's like a southern.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Thing. But Wendy's said something about how, okay, this is the whole conversation. Now we have it up.
Corporations are people.
A guy said, "So Wendy's, you just going to let IHOP sell burgers on your block? I thought you were the OG." So by the way, let's just also point out that this guy's making a joke, which is funny, I guess, that he's comparing IHOP and Wendy's to drug dealers. Fair comparison.
Fair enough.
I don't think it's a favorable comparison. So Wendy's chooses to respond to this and says, "Not really afraid of the burgers from a place that decided pancakes were too hard."
Wow. Aggro.
65,000 retweets. And then Moon Pie's so f***ing lame. Then Moon Pie has to jump in the mix.
Fired up here.
And said, "Wendy's, this is so good." 258 retweets. Really, Moon Pie? You'd embarrass yourself.
Brown nosing.
By brown nosing Wendy's for 258 retweets. And then Wendy's writes back, crying laughing emoji, "Thanks, Moon Pie." And then Pop-Tarts gets in the mix and says, "Moon Pie."
Oh, no.
Yes. "Moon Pie, I second that. And Wendy's, great work. A plus, you've earned your pay. Can we all go home now?" And then Wendy says, "This is our home now. We live here forever." And then Moon Pie said, "Oh, no." I think I made this point last time. When I see stuff like this, I used to see stuff like this and it made me hate corporations. And then the more I thought about it, it just makes me hate people. These idiotic, fake brand conversations that they're having, the reason why it's so easy for brands to do this is because when people do this on social media, they are becoming brands. So it's not even like the brands are pretending to be people.
Right.
They're just doing this weird corporate branding that people do. You know what I mean?
To brand themselves.
Yeah, so it's like, it's one thing to be like, "Wendy, stop pretending you have a personality," where you could say that, whereas it's almost more like, "Hey, like, Frank, stop pretending that you're Wendy's." You know what I mean?
Yeah.
In some way, this idiotic conversation makes more sense for a bunch of corporate Twitter accounts. You know what I mean?
Yeah, as opposed to just like between friends on Twitter.
"Jake, this is so good." "Thanks, Ezra. Seinfeld, I second that. Great work, A+. Also, let's go backwards. This entire dumb conversation between Wendy's, Moon Pie, and Pop-Tarts was precipitated by Tony X's joke about Wendy's being a rival drug dealer that should go murder IHOP for daring to sell product on their block. This is a nightmare. We should pick like the dumbest product possible. Just like something really boring. Just like plain chocolate. Whatever, it can be made very cheap with high profit margin.
Gorilla glue.
And the entire ad campaign that we do is just social media. And whenever we see a conversation like this, we get in the mix with all these brands, say, "Shut the fuck up. You're just brands. Follow me." Or you'd be the villain of this world. Like, next time Wendy's and Burger King get into a beef, yeah, just get in there and just be like, "Both of you, shut the fuck up. You're both fucking losers. Shut the fuck up." Just be the aggro.
So we should make
I think it has to
brand?
Be food.
Yeah.
Because it's mostly food brands who get into
this stuff. So we have to make like our own Time Crisis food brand.
Time Crisis Burgers.
Yep. Very straightforward.
And maybe our thing is that
TCB,
our whole thing is that, you know, like Wendy's does all that about, they claim their burgers are fresh, but they're frozen. Our whole thing will be, no, actually, maybe we hire a guy.
I like it.
Okay. You with me? We hire a guy.
Yeah, we hire a guy.
Which is like a good guy's name.
Frank?
Okay,
you
Frank.
You said Frank before. It kind of stuck with me.
Okay. Frank Kavanaugh. Irish. A lot of Irish Americans. So Frank Kavanaugh, and our whole, it's called Frank Kavanaugh Burgers. And the whole thing is that Frank is the face of the company and he does the social media. And our whole thing will be like, a lot of these brands develop these fake personalities, but behind closed doors, it's not fresh. It's a whole team of 23-year-olds. Frank Kavanaugh does his own social media. We don't need a whole team of New York, Brooklyn hipsters running our social media account. One man, one burger, one social media account. And be like, "Hey, Wendy's, you hide behind this drawing of a girl with red hair. Post a fucking picture of your social media team. Because ours is our banner. It's Frank Kavanaugh. Frank Kavanaugh Burger." You know what I mean? They want to play this stupid game? This is the edgiest time crisis ever. I think our guy's kind of like the Punisher.
Frank Castle.
Frank Castle.
Punisher burgers?
I think maybe this...
I feel like we need like a real brand name, not just some dude's name.
Oh, well, I mean, this could be part of the MCU.
Great tie-in.
Okay.
But if people saw Punisher burgers on Twitter, they'd be like, what's that? Like, they would, you know...
Punisher burgers. Who's the Punisher? It's me.
Frank Castle.
We have to find a real guy named Frank Castle who... Obviously, we wouldn't make this happen, but we do need to find a guy named Frank Castle whose family was murdered. It's almost like a... what was that that old Charles Bronson movie? Death Wish.
Right.
One righteous person... Notice I said person, because this is 2018. They got to be a female Death Wish. Come on, Hollywood. Anyway, one person...
Kind of see women killing people on screen.
It's time. But I like the idea that all these corny-ass fast food brands... who pretend to have a voice when really it's a room full of out-of-touch coastal elites with degrees from Vassar brainstorming this horse. I like the idea that just like in Death Wish or
so
The Punisher.
Much swearing on the Twitter account.
I like the idea that it's just one person. All they have is righteous indignation.
Punisher Burgers, dude.
Punisher Burgers. Say, hey, Wendy's, you're named after a girl. How come... You got 40 people in your social media department. You want to know who makes Punisher burgers? You want to know who the Punisher is? It's me, Frank. I'm one guy. Yeah, I didn't go to Vassar. Also, there's like a weird fixation on Vassar in this. And then we'll do some kind of activation across the street from Vassar. Guess what? Punisher Burgers is driving up.
Pop-up shop.
Punisher Burgers is driving up to do a pop-up shop activation at Vassar. You want to come talk to me? Come talk to me face to face. No, yeah, like Wendy's will try to be like, haha, as if. Why would we want to hang out with some weird old guy? We're young and fresh. And be like, cut the crap, Wendy's. Cut the fucking crap. No, and we'll like do weird gorilla where we like roll up to like the Droga 5 office and just like stand outside like Michael Moore style. Hey guys, it's me, Frank. I'm out front. I'm in fucking Midtown Manhattan. You believe this 85-story building. Can I get upstairs? I just want to talk to these f***ing ass pretending that they're a sassy Twitter voice. It's a bunch of f***ing hipsters up on the 85th floor. This is bullshit. Sir, you can't come in here.
Really deep, dude. I gave you fair warning. Beware. Yo, beware. What you thought public was sweet. Now you can't sleep. Gotta keep your eyes open wide and hide your face from the streets. I'm like the beast with a warrant. Far from a Norman. Gave you fair warning. Now you want to stay squalling. I'm calling out any rapper that I doubt. Smack him in the mouth. Throw him in the yoke. Boom. Then I knock him out. No doubt. Freddy Fox fouls. 20 shot. Auto block plow. Benny Blanc. Porter Rock style. With a twist of black in the brow. Twist your cap in the mouth. Sleep with the fish. Did for yapping. So now. What's not happening now, thinking it's hard as hell, but they Gargamel. Sticking on the smallest victim gives them heart to kill. My squad is real and holds it down the hardest, regardless. What size of the largest, we polish the floor with the rawest hardcore artists. Flawless victory, and niggas can't be shit to me. Physically, lyrically, hypothetically, realistically, and the epitome of catch a wreck. Catch it when you cash a check, smash it when you pass the check before you out flex. Nothing less than the best of the squad did it. Hard headed, it's better beware and fear like God said it. I gave you fair warning. Beware, beware. This bullshit's gone on too long. Wendy's getting 65,000 retweets. That's insane.
Seinfeld, what's the most retweets you ever got?
Like 50,000.
Holy cow, dude. So sincere. 50,000.
It's a real answer.
Okay.
That's crazy, dude.
Wendy's is getting 65,000 regularly. I just like the idea of just a righteous, angry force entering
Burger Twitter.
I just can't believe that this whole conversation's going down and people are just happily retweeting and nobody just steps in and just says, Moonpie, shut the fuck up. Wendy's, you're the worst of all. Pop-Tarts, get a life. You know,
maybe what? You start doing this, man.
Wendy's, Wendy's, you want to be on social media? Okay. How about do a Facebook Live? You know? You want to pretend that you're like a young
so
person?
Fired up.
Let's do a Facebook Live. Let's see who the fuck is behind this Twitter account.
Bring it, man.
A bunch of Vassar grads.
I'm on a trip now where you're doing it, and I'm picturing the New York Times.
I legally changed my name to Frank Castle.
No, it's Ezra from Vampire Weekend. And it's just like, you're on tour. You got time. You're on the road.
Right.
and you start going off on these places on Twitter, I'm just picturing the like Pitchfork and New York Times profile of like Mr. Canning's interests.
A 21st century success story. Yeah, exactly. Wait, but in your version, do I even have my own burger place or I'm just an unhinged dude?
No, you're just like unhinged. It's like you're the singer from Vampire Weekend who just like lost his mind and just started.
And then it's like BuzzFeed.
Didn't even lose your mind.
17 times Ezra eviscerated the
exactly.
Wendy's.
It just became part of your brand, man.
Okay, I'm not as into that personally. I think that might hurt my main brand, but...
It would be a weird look for the band.
I guess it would be kind of stronger than having Punisher Burgers, because Wendy's would finally just be like, haha, what's your deal, man? Get a life. Be like, I got a life, because I'm a human f***ing being.
I'm a Grammy award-winning artist.
I'm a Grammy award-winning human f***ing being. I'm not 25... Vassar grads in the 85th floor of a building in Manhattan. I'm a real person. And you know what else? I got nothing to sell.
You're just going like kind of...
Punisher Burgers went belly up in the first week. I got nothing to sell. Don't push somebody who's got nothing left.
It's almost like a weird like Dennis Leary kind of character or something.
Listen to me very carefully, Wendy's. Vampire Weekend's not touring. Punisher Burgers went belly up.
Last album flopped.
Punisher Burgers flopped. I got nothing. And you be very careful with what you say to a man who's got nothing.
This is almost like De Niro. You go taxi driver on Twitter. Whew. Jeez. It's like
a Yeah, I think that's the arc. It starts out as Punisher Burgers.
Okay, we've. This is like a 4-year plan.
I just really want to map this out.
Yeah.
It starts as Punisher Burgers.
Right.
And Punisher Burgers comes out.
So you open a Twitter account.
No, but it's for a real business that we start together.
Okay, great.
We got 5 locations.
We're going to need a lot of capital here, dude.
For the first 6 months, actually, we could do the. We could just pretend this all happened. For this first 6 months,
we can just pretend. Like, this will ever come up again. I guarantee you.
I was just saying that we were talking at Dave's show the other night about how Time Crisis is so weird because we do it every 2 weeks. It's just enough time to forget that it exists.
Yeah. Never remember what we talked about before.
We come in here, we just say all this crazy shit we forget. And I was saying how when we announced the Ojai shows and we said, oh, we're doing 2 shows, that a few people in the comments were like, oh, is this the Twix shows? And I really had to rack my brain to remember what it...
What? Yeah.
Wait, do you guys remember is this...
Yes.
Okay, so we did a joke on Time Crisis that we were riffing on how Fish did 13 shows in a row with no song repeats. And that's called The Baker's Dozen. And we said that Vampire Weekend could do 2 shows in a row with no repeats. And it would be the Twix. And we get Twix to pay for it.
Of course.
And whatever, it's left Twix and right Twix night and yeah. Whatever you vote and... You know, you enter to win a sweatshirt or something like that. But anyway, at first people were like talking about this and I was like, Twix, what's that? Like, I was like, that's funny. And I really just...
Yeah, you didn't remember.
I could understand the idea, but I just don't remember talking about it. Anyway, that's what Time Crisis is like, but not Punisher Burgers. Punisher Burgers starts and it's real. And for the first 6 months, you come out swinging very simple, elegant burgers and design. And we just come out. And just immediately, we're threatening Wendy's on Twitter. Every time they try to do one of their cutesy little conversations, we just get in there and just say...
Shutting them down.
Guys, cut the crap. You're a room full of Vassar grads. And we every single one of them, just you're a room full of Vassar grads.
Yeah.
Cut the crap. And then...
You want to talk burgers? Come down to our location.
Come down to our location.
On Eagle Rock Boulevard.
Exactly. And then 6 months in, it flops. And then... Those Vassar grads at Wendy's do something like they'll do some meme.
So we're planning from the get-go for the burger business to fail.
Yeah.
Okay, this is a long con.
And then Wendy's and Burger King and whoever.
Just pile on.
They're just doing pile on. They're just doing memes about like, oh man, yeah, another one of those they would try to turn around on us. Another keyboard gangster who talked a lot but just couldn't sell burgers. I guess that's that. I guess you'll be packing it up. Then just the next day, shut a business. Be like, yeah, we don't sell burgers anymore. Then we kind of shift into the, you know, don't push a man who has nothing.
Shift into that gear.
And then Punisher Burgers just becomes this like vigilante account to take down Vasagrads.
Couldn't you almost see, like, in a Mike Judge style way, like Burger King just getting to the point where they're just like, shut the fuck up. Like, basically what we're joking about.
Basically.
Like, ouch, my balls.
No, that was...
Like, all that Idiocracy stuff.
We talked about this, that somebody, I want to give credit to whoever it was, but I can't remember. I once saw a tweet or, like, something on Instagram that was, somebody wrote, like, fast food Twitter in 2013. Ha ha, Wendy said fleek. And then it was like, fast food Twitter 2018, Burger King just told me to go fuck myself. So people are talking about this. Okay, that's why I think this could be a hit, because people are out there, they're sick and tired of this. These fake personalities.
I'm just psyched for like month three of our burger operation being up and running, full well knowing it's going to hit the wall in 3 months.
Right.
I love the long con up, like hiring like a manager.
Right.
For like the Eagle Rock location.
And also just, because then we would say to Wendy's like, all right, guys, maybe I'm not as good as business as you. I'm not owned by a giant corporation. I don't have international capital flowing in, and our final location, the Eagle Rock location, the original, is now closed. And then they'll say what they're going to say and say like, all right, you won. And then a couple days later, that's when we come back, be like, but now I got nothing to lose. You thought you won? That was just the end of chapter one. Okay, clearly we got to stop talking about this.
Let's do another 40 minutes on that.
Punisher Burgers.
That was like literally like an hour.
Also, I like the idea of just being like doxing the accounts. Wendy's just dropping some like, how lit is our new chili? And just be like, our chili? Is it really our chili? Jessica
Johansson?
Is it really our chili? Vassar. Jessica Johansson? Vassar class of 2014? What makes it our chili, Jessica Johansson? Because last time I checked, you weren't at Hardee's this weekend. You're eating acai bowls in Williamsburg.
Pulling down $200K a year.
$200K. Okay, we got to stop talking about this. Okay,